today? Good? Good. Great. I'm doing great. I'm doing wonderful. So this is my take on a beginner's tutorial to contour, blush, highlight. The trinity of all makeup looks. I'm definitely gonna just go ahead and let y'all know now, I'm more of like a soft contour girl. I'm not like super, super, super sculpty, but catch it in that light. So we're gonna just jump on in to the tutorial, to the good stuff, to the nitty gritty. Stay divine. Stay slaying, my queens. Looking like a hypothermia snack. So I typically, when contouring, especially if you're new to contouring, I always go for like a contour palette. I mean, it's just the easiest way. Most of the time they have different tones, they have different sculpting powders, so you just got a whole palette to play with in one. Today I'm going to use the MAC Studio Fix Sculpt and Shape Contour Palette. This is in the shade Light Medium. Most palettes do come with like a 2 to 3 different color base, which is good. So here you can see we have a cool. See how that's like not as orangey? And then the middle's a neutral, and then this side you can see is more orangey, which is more warm. So cool, neutral, warm. And this all depends on the rest of your look, okay? If you want to play it safe, put a neutral on. Just put the neutral on. You know, if you want to look super like bronzed and tan, put the warm on, but be careful. And if you just kind of want like a sculpt, not really a bronzy kind of look, just you're literally going into just shade, use the cool, and again, be careful because sometimes you use too much and it can look gray. It also depends on the product. I don't have that problem with this, but then again, I've never had a problem with MAC products, so to each their own. So how we're gonna start this off is, if you do not know where your cheekbones are, most of the time people can just go and you can kind of see where it's all sitting at. If you do not know where your cheekbones are, you can always go in and feel. And where it hollows out, so where there's not like a bone and it actually goes to a hollow, that's where you're gonna wanna put your contour. I always take it diagonally from, is that a word? Anyways, from ear, like corner of the ear, I go in a diagonal towards the corner of the mouth. You can take it all the way to the mouth if you want. I don't. I just like it to look more like a soft contour. So I normally take it diagonally and I start right at this, where this smile crease is right here. So see when you make a dimple? Right there is where I stop, where that cuts off. So this is an angled contour brush. This is the MAC 168. So it's already angled, which is perfect. So if you're just starting out, even if it's not MAC, get you a fluffy angled powder brush. We're gonna go into our neutral color here. I like to generously apply it and then tap off any excess. That way you won't get any harsh like fallout and make it look like a harsh line, because we're going for contour and sculpt, but we're definitely not trying to make this a harsh line. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna start at the ear. And I'm barely applying any pressure. I'm kind of just letting the brush tips do the work for me. And I'm going in up and down, teeny tiny motions. So you see, I'm not being like super, super small, but just enough. A lot of people are scared of this, but honestly, you can see I'm kind of being a little bit lackadaisy with the up and down motion, so don't be scared. Don't overthink it too much. Whenever I worked at the MAC at Bloomingdale's in Hawaii, my third key manager, Bree Sakamaki, what's up girl, actually taught me this. And it's a technique that I have used for a really long time. So she's pretty bomb. She's a twin mom. She also has her own like accessory business, so like jewelry and hair accessories. I wear her jewelry a lot, so You know what? I'll tag her in this. Because she's bomb. So if you don't follow her, you should follow her because her kids are really cute and she always posts really inspiring stuff. And she's really good at beauty too. So she does like hair and makeup tutorials on top of like selling and like owning her own accessory business. Like, I have so much admiration for mothers who also like got their crap going for them. I have so much admiration for mothers in the first place because I feel like that's the hardest job in the world. But anyways, back on subject. Contour is basically mimicking the way sunlight hits your face. So you have natural features already. You have, some people have rosy cheeks, a hollowed out cheekbone, but you put foundation on to cover your pimps, your little pimpies, and you take all that away. So you gotta like replace that. You know what I mean? Because you make your face all one color. So you gotta go in and replace that. So when you contour, you're mimicking where the shade would hit. So if you look directly up into the sun from the side, obviously it's gonna hit the high point, which is where your highlight goes, and then this is gonna be shadowed, which is where your cheeks are hollowed out. So yeah, that's that. I take just a little bit, like whatever's kind of like left over from the cheeks, and I go in and just do a little bit on the bottom of my chin. Because again, this is shadowed. So I'm not necessarily trying to like reshape my face. I don't want to do that. I just want to give it that like natural shade to light definition. I always go in to like the temples of my forehead and like the little hairline and just dust a little bit there just to give me like an even color. And then I really like to accentuate my nose, like not in a sense where I'm willing to like harshly contour. I don't really harshly contour. Like the way I'm contouring in this video is how I do my contour all the time. If y'all wanted like a super advanced sculpting contour tutorial, I could totally do that. But I mean, that's not me, but I would do it for y'all if y'all wanted it. So I take the same brush because I'm lazy and I pinch it. So it went from like fluffy to thin. I take it and I literally just boop boop and I go and I run that from top to bottom on the sides of my nose. Not applying a lot of pressure. Again, just doing the work, letting the brush do the work for me. That's the thing. If you get good brushes, you really won't have to apply too much pressure or put too much into it, just because when you have a good quality brush, it kind of goes in and just does the work for you. Taking the same brush, again, because I'm lazy, I'm gonna go into Petal Power Mineralized Blush from MAC and swirl this bad boy around in there. So you're gonna layer it. So it's gonna go contour, blush, highlight. So I take it, and the first thing I do, again, I'm not like applying any pressure. I'm just barely letting the bristles touch my skin. And I'm gonna start on the apple of the cheek and go in circular motions. And then work it all the way back to the ear in a diagonal, just like you did your contour. The reason we do that is if you were to just put bronzer right here and not take it all the way back, it's gonna look like a harsh line. Same thing with blush. If you just take blush and you just throw it on the apple of your cheek, it's gonna be like a circle. And I mean, that's a whole look, you know, but that ain't me, so. That's why we always take it back to the ear. Hey, what you do? Okay. So then we've got highlight. Now there's two different methods. You know, you could use like a flat highlighting brush, or some people use like, they look like fan brushes. Or I've seen some people use like a small blending eyeshadow brush. This is all completely preference. I like a good, no, you know what? I'm gonna use the small one today because it's easier. So Where is my highlight I want to use? Right here. So what I'm gonna do is, and I'm so sorry, like, this little girl, she's been through a lot, but she's good. So I'm gonna take an eyeshadow brush and I'm gonna generously go into my highlight. And you know what, the smaller brush you use, the more accuracy you're gonna have. So if you start out with a bigger brush, you're more likely to get the highlight kind of all over your face versus in just the section you want, which is a lot of reason like why people go in with a smaller brush, just because they can control it more. And so for the cheek, you're gonna place your highlight on the tops of the cheekbones, again, in a diagonal. And I actually push it kind of under here too, just so it's not just like a streak. I always take it and wrap it from like the tip of the brow all the way down to the cheek. Again, this is just for the whole looking completed and together purposes. No harsh lines in this house. And when you look at the sun, it's like, oh, it hits the whole section here, so highlight it. Are you depressed? Highlight it. Are you insecure about a section of your face? Highlight it. Go in and highlight. Ooh, that was a lot. Highlight the chin. We're gonna highlight the brim of the nose. And also this little button here. You can get real intense with this if you want. I was like, I'm not gonna go too intense, but here I am just adding more. I always just do a little in the center of the forehead, if anything at all, just because the forehead's already so shiny. And the arch of the brow. If I was wearing my hair up, I would actually go in and like highlight my ears as well. I'm not wearing my hair up, but I've already gone in, so. Okay, in a nutshell, there you go. I'll snap to me being fully ready so that I don't look crazy. I look less crazy now that I have color to my face, which is another reason why I feel like this is so important, contour, blush, and highlight. Just because, like, I went from dead scrub to a live scrub. Okie dokie, that does it for our beginner to contour, blush, and highlight. Super soft. Super natch. I'm using lingo. I hope this helped. And as always, if you have any questions or if you would like me to elaborate on anything more, you're more than welcome to DM me. I don't get notifications. I have to open the app to see my notifications, so I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Y'all have a blessed day. Bye.